पैसेज फोर, देयर आफ्टर द स्पीकर फिक्स्ड फॉर एग्जामिनेशन क्रॉस एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ श्री कुलदीप बिश्नोई MLA एंड हीज विटनेसेस एंड ऑन द सेड डेट श्री बिश्नोईज एविडेंस वॉज टेंडर्ड एंड रिकॉर्डेड हाउ एवर हीज क्रॉस एग्जामिनेशन कुड नॉट बी कंप्लीटेड एंड द नेक्स्ट डेट फॉर फर्दर क्रॉस एग्जामिनेशन of Sri Kuldeep Bishnoi was fixed for 6th June 2011. In between, on 2nd June 2011, the matter came up before the division bench of the High Court when directions were given for hearing of the petitions at least every week, that is at least 4 times in a month. However, on account of the sudden demise of Chaudhary Bhajan Lal, MP and former Chief Minister of Haryana, and also the father of Sri Kuldeep Bishnoi, the disqualification petitions were adjourned by the Speaker. On 21st June 2011, the Speaker fixed all disqualification petitions for hearing on and for further cross-examination of Sri Kuldeep Bishnoi. The cross-examination of Sri Kuldeep Bishnoi was concluded before the Speaker and 5th August 2011 was fixed for recording the evidence of the MLAs. On 18th July 2011, Letters Patent Appeal Number 366 of 2011 and other connected matters were listed before the Division Bench of the High Court. The said appeal was heard on 3 consecutive days when judgment was reserved. Para. In the meantime, proceedings before the Speaker continued, and since the same were not being concluded, in terms of the assurances given, the Division Bench of the High Court directed the Speaker to file an affidavit on or before 11th November 2011. Finally, being dissatisfied with the progress of the pending disqualification petitions before the Speaker, the Division Bench took up the letters patent appeals on 2nd December 2011, when directions were given for production of the entire records of the matter pending before the Speaker. On 7th December 2011, the relevant records of the proceedings before the Speaker were submitted to the High Court, which adjourned the matter for further consideration. However, as alleged on behalf of the appellants, the bench was not constituted on 19th December 2011 and without any further hearing or giving an opportunity to the Speaker's counsel to make submissions on the status report, the High Court proceeded to pronounce its judgment on the letters patent appeals by its judgment, which has been impugned in these proceedings. The Division Bench upheld the directions of the learned single judge also para. However, while disposing of the matter, the Division Bench stayed the operation of the orders passed by the Speaker on the merger of the HJC with the INC, dated 9th November 2009. It also declared the 5 MLAs who have filed separate appeals before this court as being unattached members of the assembly with the right to attend the sessions only. It was directed that they would not be treated either as a part of the INC or the HJC party, with a further direction that they would not hold any office either. It is the aforesaid directions and orders which have resulted in the filing of the several special leave petitions before this court by the Speaker and the five concerned MLAs as a consequence of the order passed by the division bench of the High Court. The five independent appellants before us have been prevented from discharging their functions as members of the Haryana Vidhan Sabha even before the disqualification petitions filed against them by Sri Kuldeep Bishnoi could be heard and decided. Appearing for the Speaker of the Vidhan Sabha, who is the appellant in the appeal arising out of SLP number 54 of 2012, Mr. F. Nariman, Solicitor General of India, contended that this was not a case where the survival of the government depended upon allegiance of the five MLAs under consideration, since the government was formed with the support of seven independents and one MLA from the Bahujan Samaj Party para. In fact, the five MLAs against whom disqualification petitions are pending consideration before the Speaker were not part of the government when it was initially formed. Mr. Nariman contended that the learned single judge decided the issue of merger in terms of paragraph 4 of the 10th schedule to the Constitution by holding that the two orders dated 9th and 10th November 2009 were not final or conclusive, and that in any event, when the disqualification petitions came to be decided, it would be open for the Speaker to reconsider the issue of merger. The learned Solicitor General emphasized the fact that there was neither any appeal nor any cross-page objection in respect of the aforesaid decision of the learned single judge, and even if the same fail within one of the exceptions indicated in Banarasi versus Rampal, the judgment must still be held to have become final between the parties. The learned Solicitor General urged that all the decisions which had been are earlier to this judgment.